Yeah, but I mean, you know, what's for the past 30?
This is a revolution. A revolution that's being driven by a new technology. Small, lightweight cameras in the hands of every journalist. Personally issued so that every reporter has 24-hour access.
They've been searching for 3 long years.
We had a major collapse here.
It's a revolution in editing. Edit systems on every desk in the newsroom.
How are you doing?
This is about changing the nature of news.
2-1, run A.
The kind of stories we cover, the places we report from.
Oh, it's just me, sorry.
The way the stories look.
They call this boot camp for a reason. This is tough, demanding.
During the next 3 years, the BBC will train, equip and field more than 600 DV filmmakers. Reporters, correspondents and technical staff will all learn how to shoot, report and edit their own stories.
The purpose of this experiment is to invent the new television. That's what you are really here for.
How will this change television news?
Closer.
In 2000, BBC Nations and Regions covered the entire UK with 84 camera crews. By 2004, we'll field nearly 700 cameras on a daily basis.
But when you walk out of here at the end of 3 weeks, you will produce pieces like this.
The driver, a local man, has been cut out of his car.
Feed him out straight to the trolley.
Steve has to put his leg in traction.
What is a halfpipe?
This is a halfpipe.
Go on it! Good boy.
Reporters will now be able to spend more time with the people that make the news and bring a sense of depth and quality to the stories.
I was married for the first 16 years of my pipe-making career, and probably my marriage was a casualty.
I mean, I've been able to do stories that I just wouldn't have been able to do if I hadn't have had the small camera with me. It's so much less threatening to people to just have one person and have that little camera, just like the ones they've seen all the relatives have, rather than the whole telly, you know, circus rolling to town.
With so many cameras in play, we'll have a margin for error. Not every story assigned will have to make air. Good journalism requires the ability to take risks.
Freedom to fail. It's a right. Not a privilege.
The PDP person is in a unique position to spend a lot of time on a story, just go out there and take risks and do stuff that hasn't been done before.
What I need is fast love, speed dating. Take 25 girls, preferably single, and like me looking for love. Meet in a London bar with 25 guys also looking for love, each with their own identification number.
When that whistle blows, hurry date begins, and I want you to date like you've never dated before.
When I went in to ask Sandy to do a four-part series into finding love in London, I mean, he was a little bit surprised, and he didn't know me from Adam, really, and he thought, and I didn't think it would go ahead. Anyway, I went ahead and did it, and it's paid off. You know, I tried something that you wouldn't really see on regional news, and he loved it.
When finished, BBC Nations and Regions will look like nothing that's ever existed in the world of TV journalism. A new technology for a new kind of television news. One that's more intimate, more immediate, covering a broader area, bringing more depth in reporting. Covering the people and personalities of those that make the news. It's happening now, here, in Newcastle, and in newsrooms across the UK.